Performing safe blood glucose testing is a lot like an acrobat walking a tightrope. You've got to take each step of the procedure mindfully to avoid slipping into a pool of unwanted germs. Assisted blood glucose monitoring, or ABGM, is a simple fingerstick procedure performed regularly in all types of healthcare settings. But when performed incorrectly, it could put patients at risk for bloodborne infections, such as HIV or hepatitis B and C. To ensure your patient's safety, there are a number of simple steps you can take to make sure you minimize the risk of infection. First, prepare a clean and disinfected work area away from food and drinks. And always perform hand hygiene before and after cleaning a surface. Next, gather all the required supplies, but remember, do not carry any of these items in your pockets, which can hold all kinds of contaminants. Typically, blood glucose testing supplies consist of the following items: hand hygiene supplies and disinfecting wipes, disposable latex-free gloves, a blood glucose meter called a glucometer, test strips, be sure to check the expiration date before using, a single-use fingerstick device or lancet, alcohol swabs, and gauze or a bandage. Here are a few simple rules to remember about ABGM. Glucometers can be unsafe to use and can spread germs even if you do not see blood contamination. Infectious outbreaks have occurred due to improper usage of these devices. Glucometers must be cleaned and disinfected before and after each use, according to the manufacturer's instructions. If there are no instructions for cleaning and disinfection, reach out to the manufacturer to ask. But if you do not have those instructions, then don't use that glucometer. Always perform hand hygiene and put on a new pair of gloves before performing ABGM. Use alcohol-based hand sanitizer, rubbing until your hands are dry. Or if your hands are visibly soiled, use soap and water with scrubbing motions for at least 15 to 20 seconds. And please remember, fingerstick devices are always used for only one person. Now you're ready to test the blood glucose levels. Confirm the patient's ID using two identifiers, full name and date of birth. Carefully remove a test strip from the container without touching the test pad portion of the strip. Reseal the container and insert the strip into the glucometer. Set the meter according to the manufacturer's instructions. Then, choose a puncture site. With an alcohol swab, disinfect the puncture site. It's critical to let the skin air dry. Don't blow on it or wipe it. When the site is ready, prick it with the fingerstick device. Do not milk the finger. Allow the blood droplet to appear naturally. Place the testing strip onto the blood droplet. Make sure the bleeding has stopped by applying pressure on the finger with gauze. Do not wipe the puncture site with an alcohol swab. Dispose of the test strips and sharps correctly by immediately discarding the used test strip and fingerstick device into a sharps container. Now remove your gloves and perform hand hygiene. Next, take care of the glucometer. Put on a new pair of gloves before cleaning and disinfecting it. Cleaning first removes visible soil, and then disinfecting kills the germs. Remember to always follow the manufacturer's instructions for properly cleaning and disinfecting the glucometer. Finally, take the time to disinfect any surfaces that may have been contaminated. Once you're finished, store the disinfected glucometer in a clean area to avoid contamination. Consistency equals safety. And your patients or residents are safe because you follow these guidelines every time you perform a blood glucose test. All these simple steps lead to safe care.